Yo, what's up guys? It's your boy XpeK. So I'm bringing you Is It Tuesday Yet number 42. This is obviously going to be Wrath of the Machine loot times 3. I've actually done this raid about 5, maybe 6 times now already. The other extra times is honestly just to help friends beat it. My little clan and friend group is pretty big and there's a lot more than 6 of us, so I had to help, you know, a lot more than a couple groups get through in the raid. And you know, I've come to the conclusion that this raid is like a mixture of past raids, in my opinion. This raid honestly feels like King's Fall and Vault of Glass kind of wrapped into one, in my opinion. Basically, in Vault of Glass, the theme was like you're fighting for your life. It had a deep sense of exploration inside of Vault of Glass, whereas King's Fall was, you know, very mechanic heavy, filled to the brim with lore. You know, there was a significant reason behind everything inside King's Fall. And I'm starting to get the same impression from Wrath of the Machine and Vault of Glass, where I get both of those feelings. You know, looking for this fifth monitor and trying to figure out that last chest under the boss, the final boss. You know, it really gives you that sense of exploration in this raid where you can look around, being on top of that wall. I really love that feeling. It brings back some old nostalgic feelings with the Vault of Glass. I think that's what Bungie was trying to aim for. Now with it feeling like King's Fall, I say that because, you know, there's a lot of mechanics in this raid. Even though a lot of people are saying it's short or it's too easy, I do feel like there's a lot of mechanics. You know, you gotta throw the relics, kill certain enemies, be at a certain location. You can't really sit in the back and just, you know, be a cheese ball and just shoot a crit for 10 minutes straight. There's a lot of stuff you gotta do, and there's a lot of teamwork orientation that you have to do in just about every fight. So will this raid last 12 months? Probably not. You know, by the time it's, you know, New Year's and Christmas time, we'll probably be pretty bored of the raid. But you know, for now, it's really fun. I enjoy it. It's fun doing this with friends, laughing about throwing the relics, or if you miss the relic and fall off the map, we all have a good laugh. You know, we're not really going at each other's throats like we did with previous raids. I remember doing King's Fall for the first time was kind of frustrating. Same with Vault of Glass. Doing Vault of Glass the first time in hard mode was excruciating, especially if you had a group that wasn't at least 29. If your whole group wasn't 29 or 30, good luck beating Vault of Glass hard back in the day. You know, when it comes to raids, where Bungie began and where they are today, I think there's a massive improvement. I'm very happy with Wrath of the Machine so far. I can't wait to figure out this last chest. I can't wait to try out hard mode. My only gripe or groan is honestly the hoarding thing, which I've used. I'll be honest, I've used the light level hoarding sort of ordeal. But I'm also kind of, my other gripe is that not all the loot is available. Like, you can get a full armor set right now, but you can't get the hand cannon, you can't get the sniper, the machine gun is in the loot pool, so I'm guessing they're saving that for hard mode, which kind of annoys me, but it's not the biggest deal. Honestly, the auto rifle and the scout rifle are really good. Now, one thing I love about the loot in this raid is that you can actually reroll your armor, which is just amazing because I was so tired and sick of getting sidearm and like fusion loader gauntlets from King's Fall. And now in this raid with the key fragments, you can use them to reroll your armor set. So if you don't like discipline strength, you can get intellect discipline. You could get a better loader on your gauntlets. You could get sniper rifle boots. However you want your gear to be, over time you can eventually make it the way you want it. And I love that. That was something that King's Fall was missing, and that's something, you know, this is something that will probably make the raid gear much better than all the other gear in the game. With that being said, I feel the same about the raid weapons. They finally have static rolls again, like they did in year one, and I think the perks are pretty good for most of them. You know, the fusion rifle has like double the effectiveness of Armia 1, auto rifle has firefly, the scout rifle has like double down. I think over time people will get a little warm to these perks and maybe they'll use them a little bit more. In PvP, I don't see them being that good. Maybe we'll have to wait and see, only time will tell. But so far in the raid, they are very good. They do bonus damage to the fallen enemies, so that's why I like using them at the moment. But I'm probably gonna need a little bit more time to have a solid opinion on the raid weapons. But so far, aesthetically, they look really cool. They act really cool. We'll just have to see how the perks end up being. So another thing I wanted to talk to you guys about is the group I did it with. I'm actually so impressed with how well we were calm and collected. I went back and watched the VOD, basically the recording of us doing our first run, and I'm so impressed with our teamwork. You know, it is kind of cheesy to say this, but I'm actually so happy I did it with them. You know, we were calm and collected. We weren't really going at each other's throats. There wasn't a lot of yelling or bitching about, you know, very minimal stuff, and I think we meshed very well as a group, and I think that's honestly one of the reasons why we were, I think, top 50. That leaderboard thing keeps updating every day, keeps pushing us back. So when I first said we were 13th in the world, I think now it's up to like 25 or something like that. But you know, we're one of the first four groups to beat it, and that's so impressive to me. I honestly love that. And a lot of them that WoW was raiding with, I've known for years and years, and they've always been the same people. They've always been very friendly. You know, we look at each other as friends. They don't really look at me as like some YouTuber or something. They give me special treatment. We're all good friends. We all enjoy Destiny, and I love that. With every year of Destiny or with every expansion that comes out, I meet more and more awesome people, and that's just another reason why I love this game so much and why I play it so much. You know, I meet so many amazing people. Destiny Con really put a lot of things into perspective, so I'm very grateful for where I am, and the fact that I can upload for you guys is really awesome as well. So down below in the comments, I want you guys to let me know what you think about this raid so far. It's okay if it's sort of negative. Me personally, I can see how someone doesn't like this raid. You know, not every raid is for everyone. Just raiding in general may not be your forte. I know some people have a tough time getting groups together. You know, LOG experiences can be very bad. You know, you could get someone that's very demanding and very aggressive, or you could have a group that just has no idea what to do and you just want to get in and get out. So I'm pretty, you know, understanding of how some people feel on certain things. And I know this is off topic, but really quickly I wanted to talk about this as well. There's last night, the fifth monitor about that raid puzzle was found, just a monitor. You can't activate it. No one knows how to activate it because it's inside like a giant cube. If you just hop on the subreddit or maybe a word searched on Twitter, it'll come up. And you know, I'm starting to lead the, I'm having bad thoughts about it because I have a feeling it's only in hard mode or it's time gated. And this is one of like my biggest pet peeves about Destiny, is when they decide to lock something away, but it's technically available at the same time. And I have a feeling this is what this monitor is. I have a feeling this monitor is only available in hard mode or even the challenge mode maybe. It's just sort of frustrating. But again, if we find anything about this monitor, if we have any leadway about it, make sure you follow me on Twitter, because I would definitely tweet about it first. And I do have a strong feeling, a little urge, that this is how you get the initiation for this exotic pulse rifle that no one knows anything about. So as always guys, if you enjoyed, be sure to leave a comment, thumbs up, share the video. I'm thinking next week I may do a live version of this, of all the live stuff. Just let me know what your thoughts are. I can do it this way. I do like the commentary. I do like rambling about everything I have in my mind going on right now about Destiny. But just let me know what you prefer. And thank you guys for watching so much, and I'll see you next time. Peace.